Steam billows invitingly, and the delicious aroma of a bubbling hot pot fills the air. Warming body and soul, hot pots are an indispensable element of winter in Japan. This one is loaded with fresh seafood. Another one piled high with mushrooms. A luxury hot pot with prime cuts of meat. Japan's countless regional delicacies, blessings of the land and the sea, find their way into local recipes for hot pots. Hot pot cuisine, nabe in Japanese, has flourished since ancient times in Japan. It has a special significance in sumo, the national sport of Japan. Nabe can even comfort the victims of a natural disaster and strengthen community bonds. On this edition of Begin Japanology, our theme is hot pots, nabe, Japan's ultimate winter comfort food. We explore nabe's history and timeless appeal.
Hello and welcome to Begin Japanology. I'm Peter Barakan. Today our topic is a type of Japanese cuisine known as nabe, or hot pot, which is extremely popular at this time of year. In fact, if you're going out with a group of Japanese friends in the winter to have something to eat and trying to decide what kind of restaurant to go to, there's a strong probability that somebody is going to suggest going for nabe. Nabe, the word simply means a cooking pot. But because this kind of food is so popular, the word has come to mean the food as well as the pot itself. Of course, you'll find hot pot dishes all over the world, but Japan does seem to have particularly wide selection with all kinds of different ingredients and broths. First of all, let's take a look at some of the many different kinds of nabe that you'll find.
Family and friends fishing for tasty morsels amid billowing clouds of steam. This is a typical winter scene in Japan. In the colder months, the shops are full of delicious nabe ingredients, including vegetables and seafood. Seasonal ingredients are one of the key elements in nabe's appeal. Another is nabe's amazing diversity. A nabe meal involves boiling fish, meat, and vegetables in a pot placed on a tabletop heating device. You eat as the cooking continues. Typically, a group of several people gather around to share one pot. You dig straight in, plucking out the items you want to eat. You have to be with good friends because you're sharing the same pot. It gives you a feeling of camaraderie. It's just so much fun chatting over a nabe meal. A friendly gathering around a hot pot stimulates conversation. That's another reason for nabe's popularity. Nabe cuisine can be divided into three broad categories based on the nature of the broth. Ingredients. One example in this category is sukiyaki. Soy sauce, sugar, and other seasonings are used to add flavor to the beef. The original aim of heavy seasoning was to eliminate the distinctive aroma of beef. Dipping the beef in raw egg gives it a well-rounded flavor. Many nabe make use of regional delicacies, and they have come to be strongly associated with specific locations. Let's start in Hokkaido. The island's big salmon catch is put to use in the local nabe. Here they're preparing ishikari nabe. Salmon chunks and roe and vegetables simmered in a broth into which miso has been dissolved. Sancho pepper is sprinkled over the food to remove any fishy smell and enrich the flavor. Next, a nabe from Akita, one of Japan's top centers of rice cultivation. These women are making kiritampo, steamed rice that is mashed, then molded onto skewers to be grilled. This is the signature food of Akita. Kiritampo pieces are added to a broth based on chicken bones. This produces kiritampo nabe. The aromatic grilled rice goes perfectly with the hearty chicken stock. Tokyo is home to a famous nabe that dates back centuries. The pot is brimming with whole lochias, dojo, simmered in a sweet and spicy sauce. Before eating, scallions and sancho pepper or shichimi spice mix are added to the dojo nabe. Nara has a type of nabe dating back 1300 years. Asuka nabe is a mixture of chicken soup and milk. Emissaries of Tang China brought dairy products to Japan's ancient capital at Asuka, and it is said that this led to the development of the local nabe. This pleasantly mild hot pot features coarsely cut chicken, shiitake mushrooms, Chinese cabbage, and other vegetables. Fukuoka in Kyushu. This area is famed for its motsu nabe, which uses both beef and pork innards. Motsu nabe is said to date from the years after the Second World War, when low-priced offal was cooked in aluminium pots. Soy sauce and miso are the major types of broth used. Plenty of vegetables, including nira, garlic chives, also go into the pot. In Japan, every local area is known for a tasty product, and this is why nabe culture is so diverse.
I've come to a restaurant that specializes in a kind of nabe called oden, which is extremely popular all over Japan. As you can see, the soup here, it's a very clear color. It doesn't use any soy sauce. They just use dried fish and seaweed and some salt, and it has a very clear color and a very delicate taste as well. Okay, let me try some of this soup now. Oh, that's delicious. It's a very light, delicate taste. It has the flavors of both the seaweed and the dry fish. And Japan's soft water is ideal for extracting the flavors from soup stocks like dried fish, dried bonito, for example, or seaweed. Also for extracting the flavors from all these vegetables and other ingredients that go into the various forms of different nabe around Japan. Now, next, we're going to take a look at another very popular form of nabe, which is extremely important in the development of sumo wrestlers.
Sumo wrestlers slam into each other with tremendous force. The world of sumo demands strong spirit, strong technique, and strong body. One of the key factors in producing this triple strength is nabe. The hot pot dish that sumo wrestlers eat is called chanko nabe. In the late 19th century, one sumo stable took in so many trainees that it became impossible to offer them all individual servings. So the stable began making one huge hot pot that everyone could eat from. At sumo stables, the junior wrestlers take turns preparing the meals. They cook while the others train. This task is considered part of their sumo education. At this stable, the kitchen crew of three prepares a meal for around 20 people. With Chankonabe, the ingredients and seasonings are varied so that many different versions can be made. The stable master and his wife decide what kind of nabe should be made. Based on their instructions, the kitchen crew figures out what ingredients are needed and how much time is required for each process. You have to boil each ingredient properly and make broths that match what goes into the nabe. You should never overcook the ingredients. You have to manage the heat and other factors carefully to get the best flavor. It's not an easy job. The first step is to make the broth. In this pot, a chicken stock is being prepared. Extracting a delicious stock from the chicken requires relatively high heat. Any scum is carefully skimmed off. Another pot is for making stock from seaweed and bonito flakes. This one is kept on lower heat to avoid generating a fishy smell. Combining animal-based stock and seafood-based stock creates a delicious broth. Soy sauce, sake, and other seasonings are added to fine-tune the flavor of the broth. Next comes preparation of the ingredients. There are many different ingredients in large quantities, so the cooks have to be deft with a knife. Sometimes fans and supporters of the stable's wrestlers send gifts of food, and these must be incorporated appropriately into the recipe. This time, chicken is going into the nabe. The size of the chunks is calculated based on the time required for cooking. No part of the chicken is wasted. Vegetables like taro, carrot, and daikon radish are pre-boiled to make them easier to cook. When I joined the stable, all I knew was what I'd learned in cooking lessons when I was at school. The older wrestlers taught me pretty much everything. As you can see, their cooking skills are impressive. Preparing nabe together contributes to camaraderie among the wrestlers. Care is taken when putting in the ingredients. Vegetables that take longer to cook go at the bottom. Then the other vegetables and chicken. And finally, the broth is poured in and everything is left to cook. A meal of Chankonabe made possible by the wits and dexterity of sumo wrestlers. A lot of thought goes into it. A great deal of consideration for each other too. The ones who make the meal consider the timing of adding the ingredients. They consider the order for adding them to the pot. They consider how to adjust the heat. It requires attention to detail. Once the nabe is ready, the wrestlers eat in order of rank, with the highest ranking eating first. Chankonabe is a lesson in the strict hierarchy that prevails in sumo. The lower-ranked wrestlers don't get to eat with everyone else. They act as waiters. Sometimes all the ingredients are consumed before the most junior wrestlers get to eat, and they have to make do with just the broth. Chankonabe teaches the importance of ingenuity, research, and making other people happy.
This restaurant is right across the road from the main arena where the sumo tournaments are held in Tokyo, and it even features its own ring of the sort where sumo bouts are held. And this is chanko nabe, a rather high-class one. This is the seafood variety, and it's got squid, salmon, prawns, crab, scallops. Pretty good. Now, as for the kind of pots that are used for making nabe, these earthenware ones are the most common. Because they're thicker than metal pots, they conduct the heat more gently and they allow the ingredients to simmer slowly. Also, once they've been heated, they retain the heat very well, so the food stays warm, which of course is what you want. Now, it's time to delve back into history and find out a little bit about how nabe cooking developed in Japan.
Surrounded by the ocean, and with rivers tumbling down its many mountains, Japan has water in abundance. Plentiful fish and vegetables, as well as clean water everywhere, led to the development of a rich culture of hot pot cuisine. This is the hearth of a traditional Japanese house. A place like this was for both warmth and cooking. In the old days, a pot would be hung over the fire filled with plenty of water. It would be used to cook fish and vegetables, and the family would gather around and eat. The history of hot pot cooking in Japan is a long one. It stretches back 6,000 or 7,000 years. It's thought that clay pots were already being made and used in the Jomon period. Back then, people mainly boiled acorns and other nuts. Archaeological sites have yielded many clay vessels that are thought to have been used as cooking pots. This 14th century picture shows Buddhist monks at a temple. They're gathered around the hearth cooking a meal in a pot. According to Buddhist precepts, eating meat is forbidden. So fish and vegetables were the main ingredients in nabe at that time. In the 17th century, nabe pots started to become widely available. The population at large began to use braziers, making it possible to cook hot pot dishes anywhere. These developments gave rise to a new style of cuisine, small hot pots for just a few people. All you had to do was boil vegetables, fish, and tofu. This simple cuisine became very popular. Here is a poem from that time about the popularity of nabe. Barely cooked, the food just flies out of that small pot. From the poem, you get a clear sense of the race for the tastiest morsels. When the modern era dawned in the mid-19th century, nabe underwent a great transformation. A dish very different from boiled vegetables and fish appeared. It was called gyunabe. As Japan adopted Western ways, people began to eat meat. New restaurants opened that served beef in nabe. Gyunabe consists of cubed beef simmered in miso sauce in an iron pot. Unlike earlier forms of nabe stewed in plenty of water, the meat was cooked in the sauce alone with no water added. Eating beef just like Westerners did was considered a mark of progress and sophistication. Gyunabe became very popular. This technique for cooking beef to bring out the flavor gave birth to a new form of nabe cuisine. As the seasoning used in gyunabe changed, it evolved into sukiyaki. The nabe cuisine that developed from ancient times was closely linked to Japan's climate. Incorporating influences from Western cooking added a new twist to Nabe's diversity.
This sukiyaki restaurant has been in business since 1871 and was a favourite haunt of Japanese literary giants like Soseki Natsume, Ryunosuke Akutagawa and Yasunari Kawabata. The word sukiyaki itself actually goes back quite a long time. Suki is a farming implement. It's a kind of flat spade. And yaki is a kind of all-encompassing word that takes in things like roasting, toasting, baking, broiling and grilling. Back in the old days, people used to heat the metal part of the spade over a fire and then cook either tofu or fish over it. Much later on, when people started eating beef in Japan and beef was cooked in shallow pans, the same term, sukiyaki, was then applied to that as well. So when you eat sukiyaki, you have, as you can see, I've got a raw egg here in my bowl. You have to eat the beef while it's still fairly rare. They cut their beef really big here. Mmm. Mmm. Wow. I mean, that just went straight down my throat. I intended to chew on it, but it was so soft. It just literally melted in my mouth. That's really quite amazing, actually. We're going to move on now and take a look at how nabe was used very effectively to bring some comfort to the victims of earthquakes.
January the 17th, 1995. A massive earthquake hit the Kansai region in western Japan with devastating results. People were left homeless in the dead of winter and struggled to get by at evacuation sites. But victims of the disaster received a boost from hot nabe that volunteers came and served. The warmth of the nabe sustained bodies that were chilled to the bone. The Takatori shopping district in Kobe's Nagata ward was reduced to ashes by fires that broke out after the quake. 95 people died in this area. As a result of the reconstruction efforts, the shopping district has a new look today. Among the shops along this street is a small restaurant run by a woman. Her name is Miyoko Ikeda. Her own home burned down in the disaster. Her husband, Takashi, was chairman of the local neighborhood association and played a leading role in their community's evacuation center. 6 months later, exhausted from the hard work, he died of a heart attack. Ikeda found herself on the verge of despair. But to honor her husband's memory, she kept going. 3 years after the earthquake, she opened the restaurant. The house speciality is oden. Ikeda has special memories concerning the cauldron she uses to make oden. It's a huge pot, 50 centimeters in diameter. It was used to cook the nabe that helped people to make it through the toughest times at the evacuation center. When Ikeda opened her restaurant, she was determined to obtain that giant pot. She wanted to repay people for their help when the community was close to despair. I felt such gratitude for the feelings of all the volunteers. So many people brought things to us and helped us to make it through. They brought us all kinds of things. And that kept us going. Ikeda's restaurant attracts people who drew strength from the warm ingredients in that pot in the dark days of the evacuation center. Then in October 2004, a major earthquake struck Niigata in the middle of Japan. Ikeda was unable to regard it as somebody else's problem. I really feel for the victims,
In Kobe, we finally made it back this far, so I know those people in Niigata are facing 10 or 20 years of rebuilding. Ikeda was deeply grateful for the help she had once received from volunteers. So all on her own, she headed to an evacuation center in Niigata to volunteer, with the harsh winter looming. And she started ladling out the same kind of hearty nabe that had sustained her own community a decade earlier. She infused her cooking with the hope that the hot nabe would help lift the spirits of the disaster victims. As the evacuees started eating the nabe, they began to cheer up. And Ikeda went around to talk to them. I know how you feel. It's tough not having a house to go back to. Not having a home was the hardest part for us too. Later, Ikeda received many thank you letters from people in Niigata. The years she had spent perfecting nabe at her restaurant were put to good use in her volunteer work. I'm glad I opened this place, so glad, I really am. I found a good line of business. I'm not alone anymore. One big pot serving a group of hungry people. That's the essence of nabe culture. A Japanese hot pot strengthens bonds and even gives people the energy they need to keep going.
Japanese people have a big thing about harmony. It's not always easy to sense that in 21st century Tokyo, but when you're sitting around a big hot pot with a group of friends and you're all digging into it, you do get a visceral feel for that harmony. The late lamented Lowell George once sang that people say that rock and roll is good for the body and good for the soul. I sometimes think the same thing might apply to nabe as well. I'll see you again next time.
Next time we look at Japanese swords, the samurai symbol that cuts to the heart of what it means to be Japanese. Steam billows invitingly, and the delicious aroma of a bubbling hot pot fills the air. Warming body and soul, hot pots are an indispensable element of winter in Japan. This one is loaded with fresh seafood. Another one piled high with mushrooms. A luxury hot pot with prime cuts of meat. Japan's countless regional delicacies, blessings of the land and the sea, find their way into local recipes for hot pots. Hot pot cuisine, nabe in Japanese, has flourished since ancient times in Japan. It has a special significance in sumo, the national sport of Japan. Nabe can even comfort the victims of a natural disaster and strengthen community bonds. On this edition of Begin Japanology, our theme is hot pots, nabe, Japan's ultimate winter comfort food. We explore nabe's history and timeless appeal.
Hello and welcome to Begin Japanology. I'm Peter Barakan. Today our topic is a type of Japanese cuisine known as nabe, or hot pot, which is extremely popular at this time of year. In fact, if you're going out with a group of Japanese friends in the winter to have something to eat and trying to decide what kind of restaurant to go to, there's a strong probability that somebody is going to suggest going for nabe. Nabe, the word simply means a cooking pot, but because this kind of food is so popular, the word has come to mean the food as well as the pot itself. Of course, you'll find hot pot dishes all over the world, but Japan does seem to have particularly wide selection with all kinds of different ingredients and broths. First of all, let's take a look at some of the many different kinds of nabe that you'll find.
Family and friends fishing for tasty morsels amid billowing clouds of steam. This is a typical winter scene in Japan. In the colder months, the shops are full of delicious nabe ingredients, including vegetables and seafood. Seasonal ingredients are one of the key elements in nabe's appeal. Another is nabe's amazing diversity. A nabe meal involves boiling fish, meat, and vegetables in a pot placed on a tabletop heating device. You eat as the cooking continues. Typically, a group of several people gather around to share one pot. You dig straight in, plucking out the items you want to eat. You have to be with good friends because you're sharing the same pot. It gives you a feeling of camaraderie. It's just so much fun chatting over a nabe meal. A friendly gathering around a hot pot stimulates conversation. That's another reason for nabe's popularity. Nabe cuisine can be divided into three broad categories based on the nature of the broth. Ingredients. One example in this category is sukiyaki. Soy sauce, sugar, and other seasonings are used to add flavor to the beef. The original aim of heavy seasoning was to eliminate the distinctive aroma of beef. Dipping the beef in raw egg gives it a well-rounded flavor. Many nabe make use of regional delicacies, and they have come to be strongly associated with specific locations. Let's start in Hokkaido. The island's big salmon catch is put to use in the local nabe. Here they're preparing ishikari nabe. Salmon chunks and roe and vegetables simmered in a broth into which miso has been dissolved. Sancho pepper is sprinkled over the food to remove any fishy smell and enrich the flavor. Next, a nabe from Akita, one of Japan's top centers of rice cultivation. These women are making kiritampo, steamed rice that is mashed, then molded onto skewers to be grilled. This is the signature food of Akita. Kiritampo pieces are added to a broth based on chicken bones. This produces kiritampo nabe. The aromatic grilled rice goes perfectly with the hearty chicken stock. Tokyo is home to a famous nabe that dates back centuries. The pot is brimming with whole lochis, dojo, simmered in a sweet and spicy sauce. Before eating, scallions and sancho pepper or shichimi spice mix are added to the dojo nabe. Nara has a type of nabe dating back 1300 years. Asuka nabe is a mixture of chicken soup and milk. Emissaries of Tang China brought dairy products to Japan's ancient capital at Asuka, and it is said that this led to the development of the local nabe. This pleasantly mild hot pot features coarsely cut chicken, shiitake mushrooms, Chinese cabbage, and other vegetables. Fukuoka in Kyushu. This area is famed for its motsu nabe, which uses both beef and pork innards. Motsu nabe is said to date from the years after the Second World War, when low-priced offal was cooked in aluminium pots. Soy sauce and miso are the major types of broth used. Plenty of vegetables, including nira, garlic chives, also go into the pot. In Japan, every local area is known for a tasty product, and this is why nabe culture is so diverse.
I've come to a restaurant that specializes in a kind of nabe called oden, which is extremely popular all over Japan. As you can see, the soup here, it's a very clear color. It doesn't use any soy sauce. They just use dried fish and seaweed and some salt, and it has a very clear color and a very delicate taste as well. Okay, let me try some of this soup now. Oh, that's delicious. It's a very light, delicate taste. It has the flavors of both the seaweed and the dry fish. And Japan's soft water is ideal for extracting the flavors from soup stocks like dried fish, dried bonito, for example, or seaweed. Also for extracting the flavors from all these vegetables and other ingredients that go into the various forms of different nabe around Japan. Now, next, we're going to take a look at another very popular form of nabe, which is extremely important in the development of sumo wrestlers.
Sumo wrestlers slam into each other with tremendous force. The world of sumo demands strong spirit, strong technique, and strong body. One of the key factors in producing this triple strength is nabe. The hot pot dish that sumo wrestlers eat is called chanko nabe. In the late 19th century, one sumo stable took in so many trainees that it became impossible to offer them all individual servings. So the stable began making one huge hot pot that everyone could eat from. At sumo stables, the junior wrestlers take turns preparing the meals. They cook while the others train. This task is considered part of their sumo education. At this stable, a kitchen crew of three prepares a meal for around 20 people. With chanko nabe, the ingredients and seasonings are varied so that many different versions can be made. The stable master and his wife decide what kind of nabe should be made. Based on their instructions, the kitchen crew figures out what ingredients are needed and how much time is required for each process. You have to boil each ingredient properly and make broths that match what goes into the nabe. You should never overcook the ingredients. You have to manage the heat and other factors carefully to get the best flavor. It's not an easy job. The first step is to make the broth. In this pot, a chicken stock is being prepared. Extracting a delicious stock from the chicken requires relatively high heat. Any scum is carefully skimmed off. Another pot is for making stock from seaweed and bonito flakes. This one is kept on lower heat to avoid generating a fishy smell. Combining animal-based stock and seafood-based stock creates a delicious broth. Soy sauce, sake, and other seasonings are added to fine-tune the flavor of the broth. Next comes preparation of the ingredients. There are many different ingredients in large quantities, so the cooks have to be deft with a knife. Sometimes fans and supporters of the stable's wrestlers send gifts of food, and these must be incorporated appropriately into the recipe. This time, chicken is going into the nabe. The size of the chunks is calculated based on the time required for cooking. No part of the chicken is wasted. Vegetables like taro, carrot, and daikon radish are pre-boiled to make them easier to cook. When I joined the stable, all I knew was what I'd learned in cooking lessons when I was at school. The older wrestlers taught me pretty much everything. As you can see, their cooking skills are impressive. Preparing nabe together contributes to camaraderie among the wrestlers. Care is taken when putting in the ingredients. Vegetables that take longer to cook go at the bottom. Then the other vegetables and chicken. And finally, the broth is poured in and everything is left to cook. A meal of chanko nabe made possible by the wits and dexterity of sumo wrestlers. A lot of thought goes into it. A great deal of consideration for each other too. The ones who make the meal consider the timing of adding the ingredients. They consider the order for adding them to the pot. They consider how to adjust the heat. It requires attention to detail. Once the nabe is ready, the wrestlers eat in order of rank, with the highest ranking eating first. Chanko nabe is a lesson in the strict hierarchy that prevails in sumo. The lower-ranked wrestlers don't get to eat with everyone else. They act as waiters. Sometimes all the ingredients are consumed before the most junior wrestlers get to eat, and they have to make do with just the broth. Chanko nabe teaches the importance of ingenuity, research, and making other people happy.
This restaurant is right across the road from the main arena where the sumo tournaments are held in Tokyo, and it even features its own ring of the sort where sumo bouts are held. And this is chanko nabe, a rather high-class one. This is the seafood variety, and it's got squid, salmon, prawns, crab, scallops, pretty good. Now, as for the kind of pots that are used for making nabe, these earthenware ones are the most common. Because they're thicker than metal pots, they conduct the heat more gently and they allow the ingredients to simmer slowly. Also, once they've been heated, they retain the heat very well, so the food stays warm, which of course is what you want. Now, it's time to delve back into history and find out a little bit about how nabe cooking developed in Japan.
Surrounded by the ocean, and with rivers tumbling down its many mountains, Japan has water in abundance. Plentiful fish and vegetables, as well as clean water everywhere, led to the development of a rich culture of hot pot cuisine. This is the hearth of a traditional Japanese house. A place like this was for both warmth and cooking. In the old days, a pot would be hung over the fire, filled with plenty of water. It would be used to cook fish and vegetables, and the family would gather around and eat. The history of hot pot cooking in Japan is a long one. It stretches back 6,000 or 7,000 years. It's thought that clay pots were already being made and used in the Jomon period. Back then, people mainly boiled acorns and other nuts. Archaeological sites have yielded many clay vessels that are thought to have been used as cooking pots. This 14th century picture shows Buddhist monks at a temple. They're gathered around the hearth cooking a meal in a pot. According to Buddhist precepts, eating meat is forbidden. So fish and vegetables were the main ingredients in nabe at that time. In the 17th century, nabe pots started to become widely available. The population at large began to use braziers, making it possible to cook hot pot dishes anywhere. These developments gave rise to a new style of cuisine, small hot pots for just a few people. All you had to do was boil vegetables, fish, and tofu. This simple cuisine became very popular. Here is a poem from that time about the popularity of nabe. Barely cooked, the food just flies out of that small pot. From the poem, you get a clear sense of the race for the tastiest morsels. When the modern era dawned in the mid-19th century, nabe underwent a great transformation. A dish very different from boiled vegetables and fish appeared. It was called gyunabe. As Japan adopted Western ways, people began to eat meat. New restaurants opened that served beef in nabe. Gyunabe consists of cubed beef, simmered in miso sauce in an iron pot. Unlike earlier forms of nabe stewed in plenty of water, the meat was cooked in the sauce alone with no water added. Eating beef, just like Westerners did, was considered a mark of progress and sophistication. Gyunabe became very popular. This technique for cooking beef to bring out the flavor gave birth to a new form of nabe cuisine. As the seasoning used in gyunabe changed, it evolved into sukiyaki. The nabe cuisine